Hello and welcome to Just Random Content with your host, Biggles. Today we are in the USS Kismet. This is a protostar class starship. I think let me do a little bit of admin first, and then we will carry on with today's personal and universal endeavors. In the meantime, let me explain what the Kismet is. It's named after a legendary crocodile. And it is a protostar class, as I mentioned before, but it's not cannon-built. It is what the protostar is capable of being built as, if that makes sense. So it's a potential build. I must admit, it is a tough little ship, if you consider how small it is. In fact, I think it probably is one of the smallest ships in Starfleet history. I wonder what weight class it could be. I'm thinking Frigate? Let me know in the comments what you think. Okay, so we'll still do a space TFO, nevertheless. I just realized I had the Airwolf theme running. I think in future I need to actually do that as a added edit for videos rather than have it with a recording. Alright, let's see, what shall we do? Left with it, so I might as well do it. Okay. feels so easy today. Good luck and have fun. I just realized I'm missing a console.
There's a break in the incoming warp signatures. We'll have a short amount of time before more Borg arrive. Long-range sensors show larger vessels incoming.
Give them cover!
evacuation ship is launching! Give them cover! Simulators! Keep fighting!
Good game. Alright, I saw where the problem is, and it's kind of odd, to be honest. Her primary systems are not the ones that I actually had selected. You know, the warp core, the shields, impulse, all of that. Deflector. Yeah, not the set that it should have. And I don't know why. Let's go remedy that. There is no way I would have changed it. So it must be some kind of bug. That is really annoying.
No.
So what ship will have it now? No, hold on. I didn't see that. I think that's a bit of a problem. Where the issue was.
Security teams, report to Club 47.
Oh, I'll check something. Glad I fixed that problem. I'll just have to get that console in the right place. So it was actually my fault. It does need to be upgraded though. Everything else is correct. The console should have appeared automatically, but I don't see it. There it is. Fixed. Actually, let me do the universal first. Oh, it is. Oh, my bad. It is a ground one. For some reason, I thought binary circuit was space. This is gonna take. Well, let me go and do some Tholians and Borgs along. Of this incredible star motion system. Clever than I've ever been for. I fixed that in time. Looks like it. Well, we'll be waiting. Okay, never mind. Wow, it's been a long time since we've done this.
Welcome
one.
To Borg Cooperative Cube Designation 14.
Good luck and have fun.
Thank you. a second challenge.
That went well. Good game. Okay. Well, all endeavors have been completed. I think let's go to Gonkra, or should we try Starbase 234? Yeah, let's start with Starbase 234. Hold on a sec while I get the combat log ready. To be honest, I cannot recall how I did it last time. Okay, that is doing something weird. There we go. Thank you for your patience. I must not forget to actually activate the combat log. I tend to do that. Thank you. I had forgotten. That was a rot. I think the ship does lack a bit of firepower, but it's not too bad. Let's head back home. Considering the ship's size, I think she is actually quite powerful. I mean, she is so small she doesn't even have turbo lifts. Or any lift for that matter, if I recall. And that will be all for today. Let's have a quick look at the combat log. Sorry, it seems to be a little unstable for some weird reason. Yeah, she lacks a bit of firepower, but she's not that bad. Right, that concludes the video for today. Remember, if you like my channel, you're welcome to donate by using the QR code or the link in the description below under coffee. Please don't forget to like, comment, follow, share and click on notifications. Are appreciated and known.